Test.
Hello, everyone. Hope you can hear me okay. My name is Sid Flupp. I'm founder of the Uberly Cat Reforest. I'm going to show a password generator called Passy. And there's a kind of a peculiar network floating around here called GoToWebsite. So if you connect to that and go to the website, which is up there, you'll see this. And you can copy paste some information if you want. Have my contact information there, pantsbud@gmail.com. So this is Passy Pass. Been carrying this one around with me for about 6 months. This is my prototype. So password generator, we have four buttons that hold cords, the user key and a password key. So I have ABCD and a user key and a password key. And let's just log in with it. You can have, you have to sign my guest book. All right, so touching the keyboard here, type in our username, type in our password. This looks like a standard USB keyboard to computers, requires no software for installation or anything like that. You can pretty much use it as your car keys, quite frankly. I have plugged into a whole bunch of people's computers with it. So let's change our password. Profile, I imagine. Account settings. All right, so we want a new password. Type the press user, that generates a new password. The randomness is seeded off delays in key presses. So I'm not a cryptographer, but it's better than just a plain seeded pseudo random number generator. Type it in again. Type in our old password. And change it. Profile's been updated. Now if we go to an editor here, this is how it interacts. Open up a bigger window here. All right, open up a text editor, hold down all the keys, press the user key, and it types out a menu as a keyboard. That's how you interact with it. We want to edit one of our slots. We edit slot AB, which contains SigFlup, but I just authenticated with. Are you sure? You want to change it? Yeah, we're sure. We want to keep the username. And we want to use the, the E key is kind of giving me here. All right. We want to use the scratch password. At this point, we can generate a new password or enter one in or do whatever we want. We want to use the scratch password. So now it's done. You can unplug it. Plug it back in. It doesn't matter. You don't have to configure it or anything like that. Now we log out. Log back in. Oh, there we are. With our username, our new password. There. We've changed our password without even seeing it, which is a good thing. I've been carrying this around for a while and it contains all my passwords. It's pretty simple. Little microcontroller, that's about it. USB microcontroller and Atmel microcontroller. And so, passwords stink. How many here use BBSs? Anyone ever used the BBSs in the 90s? Anyone on? Alright, checking to see if we had the sysop. When I started using passwords back then, they were horrible, and I thought they were horrible, and I kept it to myself because I just assumed it was me that I was making horrible passwords. And I had run a couple of BBSs, one called Shark Sandwich, one called It Was Shark Sandwich, and the sysopt logged in, and the thing with the BBSs was the sysopt was always watching, and I was in my bedroom, and I heard the click. I went over to my monitor and turned it on, I don't know, like 14 or something like that. And his password was his BBS was and he used the same password for his BBS that he did with me, which is horrible, right? But all passwords are horrible. That was a good number of years ago. Now we have the Gawker compromise where we have passwords like password, both an O, the old being for security, I imagine. The idea that we're authenticating to a remote server using a password, a very weak secret, one that's based on our daughter's birthdays or whatever, that's in our heads, is horrible. We should be authenticating to something that's a lot stronger of a secret between you and the server, but everyone uses passwords anyway. And the idea that you have to remember them is bloody horrible. Humans should not deal with this randomness whatsoever. We'll come up with names and stuff like that. I've used passwords like cueball. I think that was one of mine. And so this is my solution. This is the first iteration. I'll probably go through a couple more iterations. So it's a corded system. All the keys are the menu. The user key alone generates the scratch, and the P types the scratch password. So that's a total combination of 14 passwords. And so the next generation, I'll probably want to put maybe like 3 keys there so you can select before I hit a cord. The idea is that I don't want to go through key iterations, like, oh, type to get through a password. I just want there. And so the extra keys might be a good thing. Another thing I was thinking about, this memory stinks. It's really, really small. And so if we're going to have a bigger memory, it has to be external if we're going to use that microcontroller. And if it's an external memory, we might as well use smart cards. And so maybe a device that looks like a smart card on top of it. You can put the card in, that stores your passwords. That then giving you the opportunity to copy passwords into other smart cards, should that be what you want to do. How much time do I have left? That's about it? All right, cool. Thank you.